What's going on, guys? This is Kaishiro. Welcome back. So we are back with another Uncrowned Kings Local Metagame Report video that will cover tournament results and decklist reviews for the past couple of weeks. We have October 6 to October 18. So we are going to have a second part of this video very soon on October 19 to October last week of this month. So without further ado, let's start. At first here, we have Velocity Weekly Tournament. At first, we have Virtual World Centurion, so very distinct deck build here from the first place Joe. I guess the aim of this deck is still the same from the Centurion shenanigans. It aims to turbo out the Calamity, of course, because Calamity is such an absurd card that instantly wins you the game. But with Virtual World, you have more options to play around and you have more workable solutions to go into the Calamity route, or you can do something different. And you can break boards easily with the rank XYZ toolbox of extra deck of Virtual World that is able to access Zeus. So yeah, this is a very interesting decklist here from Joe. And then moving on, we have Yu-Gi-Oh! Davao Mindanao Gaming. At first here, we have Trap Tricks. So Trap Tricks is a very solid budget deck, if I must say. You just have to buy a couple of structured decks, 3 copies, and you just add your hand traps like Ash Blossom and Infinite Impermanence on the deck and you're pretty much good to go. This list doesn't even have Ash Blossom, no? As we can see, he did play Nibiru and Droll Lockbird to counter much more faster and combo decks on this format. So very interesting list here from Chloe J. Del Puerto. I guess this is a budget deck list. Oh, it's not. It has Zeus and Typhoon on the extra deck and Otherworld Goddess as well. The Ash Blossom was on the side deck. I see, very interesting from Cloyd. And main deck goes in match, I guess it can really stun many people's deck right now on the format. And then next we have Rescue Ace in Full Spoil, so nothing too extravagant here. Just a standard deck list of Rescue Ace in Full Spoils from Harold. The gist of this list is only running one Veiler and place double Imperm on the main deck. Most often than not, I would see more copies of Veiler on Rescue Ace because their spell and trap zone is very much occupied with the Shed shenanigans of the Turbulence. So yeah, I think Veiler should be included here rather than Imperm, but I guess this is a pretty solid list. And he is playing Darin Force on the main deck, very interesting. I guess he wants to prioritize going first on this list, and on the side deck, he played the Dogwood. So yeah, there's a lot of combo decks that are running around the format that summons a lot on a single turn, like Pendulum Magician and Dragon Link. All of those combo heavy decks are running on the format right now. That's why it really makes a lot of sense to run Dogwood right now on the OCG format to win on time, of course. And then moving on, we have Bandung Duelist Banlist Tournament. At first place here, we have Anand Dragon Link. So I have said earlier, there's a lot of combo decks on the format right now, like this Dragon Link. So this is a very TCG-esque build of Dragon Link, no? He has this player plays Black Metal Dragon on the main deck and Chaos Levenir on the main deck as well. So this is a really combo-ish version of Dragon Link and 45 card main deck. Quite extensive, but I guess this works because there's a lot of 1 card 2 card combos on the deck that you can always capitalize using the Dragon Link. On the side deck, it's pretty interesting that he plays Book of Eclipse, no? Because some decks right now are lacking Omni Negate protection from their board. That's why this card can be very effective on dealing against those decks with no Omni Negate protections. So yeah, very interesting here from Anand. I'm not really sure if this is a guy or girl, but yeah, moving on. We have Centurion, pure Centurion, no? This is a more spacious Centurion. It offers a lot of space on the main deck so that you can incorporate and adjust it to the metagame that have been shaping on your locals or your tournament that you are participating. So yeah, a really small engine of Centurion on the deck and played a lot of going second cards on the main deck. Really interesting, he played the double Talents and Trust on the main deck so that he can go second easily, and then cards of Raigeki and Lightning Storm and Forbidden Droplet really polishes his going first rather going second capability. On the side deck, he is lacking two cards, no? But he played There Can Be Only One on the side deck. Quite interesting, maybe if his opponents figured out that he wants to go second, maybe he will side the Tsibu on the main deck when going first, no? And then next, we have Ukup, third place, Centurion Horus. So this is the more standard version of Horus right now, with the rather Centurion with Horus engine right now, because this is the most explosive version of Centurion right now, and it gives more resiliency to the deck. You have options like rank 8 monsters like the Harbinger that can give you extra negations on the board, so that your board would be more protected. And of course, the Centurion is a massive deck right now that can bring out the Calamity, like I have said earlier. So yeah, this is a really solid list from Ukup. And place the Artifact Lancer on the side deck, very notable because you want to answer Rescue Ace as much as possible on our format right now. I really don't know what the card is between Judgment and Cosmic Cyclone. I forgot the name, but yeah, it's a very spicy one here on his side deck. And then fourth place here, we have Cal, purely, so nothing too spicy or extravagant here on the main deck. Quite standard. A place draw on the main deck, I would rather see Ghost Mourner here in place of Droll and Lockbird, but I guess his format is pretty much combo oriented. That's why I really get the logic of playing Droll and Lockbird on the main deck here rather than Mourner. So yeah, very interesting. And on the side deck, triple sphere mode, so yeah, very destructive against combo decks right now, because purely doesn't spend their normal summon most of the time. So yeah, they are pretty much free to use the sphere mode to break boards of their opponent. And DD Crow, no? Very interesting. Most decks here are not affected by DD Crow anymore. There's no tier lemons anymore on our format. So yeah, DD Crow can be quite strange right now. And then moving on, we have Duelo Iloilo. At first here, we have Swami, Fox, Champion, Fire King. So this deck rose into popularity after the release of the new Fire King structure deck. It really gave light for that Fire King to rose and compete with the very best decks on the format. So yeah, as we can see, this is a very strong deck right now, paired with Sinful Spoils. This is a deck that can go first and establish quite considerable amount of interruptions, and can also go second with the amount of going second cards on the Fire King inherently that can break boards like their rank 8 monster, and they can also go into the Dingirisu and Zeus easily. So yeah, this is one of the most popular and powerful decks right now. On the side deck, it's really interesting. I place Jinzo. This is a very interesting deck here from Swami Fox, because Jinzo can literally stop the Labyrinth, because Labyrinth is very much popular right now being a trap deck. Jinzo can easily halt the strategy of Labyrinth, and also Centurion is very much affected by Jinzo, because the cards of Centurion are treated as continuous trap cards when it is placed on the spell and trap zone. That's why Jinzo can really shackle the strategy of Centurion. This is a very funny yet interesting inclusion here from Swami. And then moving on, we have Ronel Pendon. We have Draco Slayers, no? So yeah, this is a very different take from the usual Pendulum Magician that we are seeing recently. This is a more conservative version of the Pendulum deck right now, a more controlling manner, but it can still combo off using the cards here from the Pendulum Magician, like the Joker and the Supreme King cards here. So yeah, this is a very interesting deck from Ronel Pendon. Place the what do you call this, Royal Decree on the side deck. It also functions the same manner as Jinzo. It can stop trap cards on the game, and also can really hurt the Centurion, which is very popular right now in our country in the Philippines. So yeah, this is a very spicy inclusion here from Ronel. And then next, we have Earl Camara, another Tier Lemons Zombie Horus, another variant of Tier Lemons, no? I wonder where will be the time that we won't see Tier Lemons anymore, but now we also have seen another version of Tier Lemons here with Zombie. So yeah, this coping mechanism on Tier Lemons, because this aims to summon out the Zombie Bonfire using the Horus. And also, the zombie adds more ceiling to the tier laments that are very much needed to the deck because the deck have lost the Ishizu Millers, the Kelbeck and Agido. So now they have to rely on other engines to make the deck more competitive. So yeah, this is a very interesting list here from Earl Camara, Attorney Earl Camara from Iloilo. And Atay Spell Fragrance on the side deck, very interesting. This is also notable because Pendulum Magician will really struggle around the anti-spell fragrance. As we all know, they are treated as spell cards on the pendulum scale. So yeah, the inclusion of anti-spell fragrance can really hurt the deck earlier of Ronel Pendon. And then next we have Pendulum Z Arc Magician. So yeah, another pendulum here. I really see why Earl Camara played the anti-spell fragrance to hurt these pendulum decks on the locals of them. So yeah, on the side deck plays Pankratops, no? So it can really out floodgates like anti-spell fragrance and summon limit, which is very popular on side deck of many players right now, like purely players. So yeah, Pankratops makes a lot of sense right now. And triple cosmic cyclone, so he really does respect the back row strategy right now and the cards that may stun the pendulum mechanic. So yeah, very good approach here from Patrick Ursua. And then moving on, we have Unesa Duelist Alliance United. At first here, we have Kashtira. So yeah, this is a quite unusual site here because Kashtira has been not doing really well lately. I guess the deck fall off from the metagame because they have lost so many key components on the deck already. And yeah, I think this deck is still good on locals level and other lower tiered competitions, but I don't see this deck tapping on big events except if the format will really revolve on the graveyard. Of course, Arisart can definitely halt the graveyard mechanic decks on the format. So yeah, very interesting here. And then next we have Fabian. We have Dragon Link, no? So Dragon Link with more hand traps, no? He had played Droll and Wailer on the main deck, and even main decking one copy of Harpy's Feather Duster. So he really does have a lot of space on the main deck, quite shy from the usual Dragon Link, which has a lot of combo pieces on the deck, and plays the Virtuous Ecclesia on the deck. Yeah, if I'm remembering things correctly, this is from the Sword Soul. So he incorporates a small branded engine on his list so that he can capitalize on the Bestial package. So yeah, very interesting. Then next we have another Fire King. So this time with Nephthys and Blaster, no? This is very interesting. I guess this deck wants to go second most of the time because he played the Lightning Storm and Book of Eclipse and Raigeki on the main deck and Kalis as well. So yeah, no Ash Blossom on the main deck, really interesting. But instead plays Wailer and Nibiru the Primal Being. Very interesting here from Yaya. And then next, we have Yu-Gi-Oh! Davao Mindanao Gaming. We have Alfred Zamora, Scareclaw Horus Adventurer. So this guy is really a menace on Mindanao. He's been playing Scareclaw and Adventurer for quite some time already. He's been playing that deck and he's been successful with it. So it's really an exciting moment every time I see his adventurer Scareclaw tapping on his locals in Mindanao. So now he has taken a different approach. He has played more engines on the deck with Horus inclusion. So yeah, this gives more ceiling on the deck, can give extra negation with the Photon Lord, can even go second with the help of Centurion Rank 8 toolbox. So yeah, this is a very interesting here from Alfred Zamora, a very interesting decklist here. So on the side deck, he focuses on different variants of hand traps. We have Ghost Ogre, we have Ghost Bell, and Droll Lacquerbird. These three hand traps are very much important to answer the format right now. We have Droll Lacquerbird to stop the Purely, we have the Ghost Bell to stop the Labyrinth, and we have Ghost Ogre to stop the Runic and Centurion. So yeah, I really recommend the hand trap options on the side deck of Alfred right now. And then moving on, we have Cloyd del Puerto, Fire King. So this time plays Power Sink Stone on the side deck and there can be only one. So he has options to go first on this deck list when his opponent wanted him to go first and break boards, because this deck is very weak to evenly match and other board breakers. So yeah, this deck could really struggle when they don't have the capacity to negate and interrupt the opponent when they went first and prevent those board wiping cards like evenly matched. So yeah, this is a very countermeasure and preventive measure from Cloyd to include There Can Be Only One and Power Sink Stone when going first. And also Dark Hole with Dark Hole Dragon niya. Very interesting because he capitalizes on destroying cards. So yeah, it really makes a lot of sense to include that Dark Hole here and the Dark Hole Dragon. And then moving on, we have Art Villanueva, Scareclaw Visas. So another Scareclaw variant. So Scareclaw is pretty much popular on the Mindanao region here in the Philippines. So yeah, this time, this is a very notable that he wants to go second on this deck. He played Triple Mind Control, which is very unusual right now. Most people doesn't even play the Mind Control. And even more so, he played Change of Heart on the main deck. So yeah, he wants to capitalize on the free bodies on the field that can go into Link Summoning for him. So yeah, this is a very neat decklist here from Art. And then moving on, we have RV Odoya, Vanquish Shoal. So nothing too extravagant here, just the usual Vanquish Shoal with Small World and the Vanquish Shoal Trap, no? So yeah, place Beastel Magnemut and Dimension Shifter could really make a lot of sense because those are dark targets to reveal. So yeah, very interesting here. And then moving on, we have Duelo Iloilo, another tournament from Iloilo. I think this is the same Fire King decklist here from earlier, but now with Nephthys on the side deck, yeah. And Dark Ruler No More. So Dark Ruler No More is pretty much underrated right now. Most people doesn't really rate their NM right now, but this tech could really shackle some combo decks right now on the format. This could hurt a lot of combo heavy decks on the format. So yeah, I think DRN Dark Ruler is a good call here. And then next we have Earl Camara with Orcus Scrap Horus. So yeah, he really wants to pop off when capitalizing on his graveyard mechanics and shenanigans using the Horus, dumping the Orcus monsters using the discard fathers of the Horus. And also the scrap engine gives him more ceiling on the deck that can give him passage and gateways to a lot of combos on this list. So on the side deck, Triple Chaos Hunter, very interesting. And Adventure, maybe he played against Adventure decks or other token decks like Sword Soul. That's why he has Token Collector and Skullmeister as well, very interesting. So Earl Camara is one of the most interesting players that I have seen earlier recently on his side deck pattern, no? Then moving on, we have Order of the Duelist in Albay, Top 8, Rika San Avalon, so Carl Steven Renevera, our friend from Kai Duelist. So he's a really exceptional Rika player, and it's no surprise that he is topping events on his community. So yeah, nothing too extravagant here. Played the Tyrion's package to give him more Omni-Negate protections on the going first basis of this deck, with the Regulus providing extra protection on his board. So yeah, moving on, we have Jomar Maravillas, another Duelist in Albay tournament. We have Labyrinth here, champion decklist. So yeah, this is a more old-fashioned decklist of Labyrinth. He played the Furniture Labyrinth rather than the Arias and Trap Heavy variant of Labyrinth. So this Labyrinth is still the same, capitalizes on the Furniture cards. And he even has Ijuzu cards, millers, rather shufflers from the graveyard. So yeah, very interesting. And then moving on, we have another Order of the Duelist in Albay. Second place of the tournament, we have Branded. So this Branded plays the Idolak, no? So most people doesn't really play the Idolak on Branded anymore because it really can be quite a disadvantage when the opponents has certain outs to the Idolak. But yeah, I guess this could work still on the format right now. And then moving on, we have Bandung Duelist tournament. At first here, we have Ukup Centurion. I guess this is the same player from earlier, but now he played double talents on the main deck. This could really address the midrange oriented format that we are currently having right now on our OCG metagame, because most decks right now on the metagame are midrange oriented, like purely Rescue Ace and Centurion Pure. Those decks are pretty much midrange and place a lot of hand traps That's why talents can be very essential on dealing against those decks. And on the side deck, played Kurikara. This can be really devastating against Purely and other combo decks if they don't have countermeasures against Kurikara. So yeah, this is very interesting from Ukup once again. And then next we have Dino here from Tigar. So I think that I have seen him from previous tournaments already on Indonesia, if I'm correct. Yeah, Dinosaur here with Scrap Engine, with Scrap Raptor, and some really interesting cards here on the deck. We have the Doodletoon. I forgot the name of this archetype, no? So on the side deck, it's pretty much going second all over the place. He has played Lightning Storm, Book of Eclipse, and Trust, and Dark Ruler No More, and Evenly Match. So he has no problems going first because he can confidently make negations to protect his board like Barone, Apulusa, Dolka, and even more so protecting his IP Mascarena. So yeah, this is a very solid list from Tigar. And the next we have Owen Unchained. So yeah, Unchained is really popular on the TCG but not the same on the OCG because we do have Maxi, of course. Unchained would really struggle around Maxi, but this is a very powerful deck right now and should be respected at that extent. And look at the side deck, he played Torrential Tribute and the Druma Cannon. So this could really be beneficial when going first. It can really make things easier for him to entrap his opponents and just capitalize on destroying the monsters of opponent using this Unchained. So yeah, this is very powerful and sound list here from Owen. And then next we have Alel, Fire King, Diabol Star. So main deck, Super Poly. This is very notable because Super Poly is very much on high status right now because this can single-handedly stop the Centurion shenanigans using Super Poly on the Legasha and the what do you call this? Crimson Dragon. So yeah, Super Poly can really make a lot of sense here from Alel. And on the side deck, Triple Dogoran. So he really wants to answer Purely, I guess, on the side deck pattern of his. And then moving on, we have CBD, Central Borneo Duelist Tournament, weekly tournament. At first here, we have Branded. So this is a very TCG SK tournament. I really assume that this is a TCG one, no? Oh no, it's a OCG tournament. It has Double Call by the Grave. So yeah, this has no hand traps almost on the deck. He played only one copy of Nibiru. Very interesting. This is a very TCG approach on Branded. And then next we have Ignister here. So it's been a long time since I have seen Ignister top already. I think this deck can still go toe-to-toe with the meta, even without the Matmech engine, because Arrival is such an immense card to deal against and most decks right now doesn't have an out against the Arrival, no? So yeah. And then next we have Sprite, Evil Twin Sprite, no? So with Melfi as well. So this is a very interesting list here from Admin, third place Admin, yeah. So played Book of Moon on the main deck, could really be good against Centurion as well and other matchups. Quite a Walmart version of Book of Eclipse right now on the main deck of this player. And then another fourth place here from Adit, Labyrinth. So this is what I'm saying earlier, a more trap-oriented version of Labyrinth using the Arias. And he played Rivalry on the main deck, very interesting. Rivalry could really stun a lot of decks right now on the format, like Runic, which capitalizes on Floodgates right now. And then moving on, we have Duelo Iloilo. So another tournament from Iloilo. They have been very active on their tournaments. We have Court Fox, another Evil Eye here. So yeah, it's the first Evil Eye, no? So this is a very interesting Evil Eye list. He played Metaverse on the deck, so it can fetch his field spells and even playing Necro Valley. So this is a control variant of Evil Eye with the Demise and Extravagance. So yeah, he even side-decks his Maxi on this list, so he really wants to go first and dominate the game. And then next we have Earl Camara, Horus Infernity. Wow, very interesting. Earl Camara never ceases to amaze me on his deck building approach. So this time, a stun-oriented and control-oriented version of Horus. So he wants to build bodies on the field using the Horus and Infernity. to sit up on those monsters and control the tempo of the game using these cards like Compulsory and Mirror Force and Ice Dragon Prison and Crackdown. So yeah, very interesting list here from Earl Camara. And then next we have Swami Fox, another Fire King. I guess it's the same decklist from earlier, yeah, with the Jinzo. And we have Shen Xian, Shen Ekang, Supreme King, Abyss Actor. So yeah, another Pendulum deck on our block right now. Most people really don't know how Abyss Actor operates, and even I don't know how this deck functions, to be honest. But yeah, he played the Supreme King on the deck, so it could really higher the ceiling of this deck, and this deck could be more explosive using the Supreme King. And then next, we have Duelo Iloilo, another tournament from Iloilo once more. We have the Unchained here from Earl Camara. So this time Unchained, more standard variety of his options from his very distinct decks from earlier. So yeah, Unchained pretty much the same. Place the Nightmare Gryphon on the side, extra deck rather. And yeah, pretty much a standard deck this here of Unchained. And next we have Drytron. So Drytron have been surprising us lately, because this Drytron had a resurgence on the metagame. Drytron even had an appearance on Japanese tournament tier list, and even placed on tier 3 right now on Japanese metagame tier list. So yeah, Drytron has been resurfacing on our format right now, and it really makes a lot of sense, because most people have ditched their Forbidden Droplet and Dark Ruler No More in place of more proactive hand traps like the Ghost Bell and Ghost Ogre. So yeah, if those cards like Droplet and Dark Ruler No More that can answer the Omni Negates are being dropped off on the cards of many people, I guess that's where the part where Drytron comes alive on our format. And place the Typhoon on the side deck could really make a lot of sense, because it could counter the Pendulum Scales of the Pendulum Magician and Pendulum decks, and also could counter the Centurion targeting their Spell and Trap Zones monsters on their side of the field. And then next we have Spencer Go with Centurion Horus, quite standard decks of Centurion. Place Ghost Bell and Ghost Ogre. Like I have said earlier, these hand traps are very essential right now to answer the meta. And also on the side deck, pretty much concise. He has balance of going first and going second. He played There Can Be Only One to go first, and also Lancea and Droll to answer Rescue Ace and Purely. Very interesting here from Spencer Go. And next we have Victisoro, another Dino here. So Dino is pretty much popular in the Philippines, and many players have been playing Dino for quite some time here in our country. And this time with the Nemesis engine that can go into the Thunder Dragon Colossus, because Colossus is pretty much game over for most decks right now. Purely will hardly lose against the Colossus, and even Pendulum Magician would struggle around it. So yeah, Colossus could really make things tough for a lot of the meta decks right now on the format. And then next we have Ronel Pendon with Pendulum Magician Z-Arc. So on the side deck, he played Mystical Space Typhoon. Very interesting, because if you don't have the capacity to discard one card from the Twin Twister, and also you don't want to spend your life points using the Cosmic Cyclone because you might lose on time, I guess MST could really be the perfect card for you to just interrupt the Centurion right now and answer back row shenanigans on the format, and Floodgates as well. And the next we have Patrick Ursua, fifth runner-up. So yeah, it's the same decklist as earlier, I assume, no? If I'm seeing things correctly. We have Mike Gloria here, 6th runner-up, Volcanic. Wow, very interesting. So this deck aims to burn the life points of opponent. So yeah, it's pretty much self-explanatory. And on the side deck, it's really quite amusement for me. He played Magic Cylinder and Lightning Vortex. Those brings back the time when I am playing the Yu-Gi-Oh! GX game on the PSP emulator. So yeah, very unusual here from Mike Gloria. And then next we have Carlo Benaflor with Rescue Ace Sinful Spoils. Main deck, Summon Limit, no? So yeah, you could really control the tempo of the game when you go first and just flip the Summon Limit to mitigate and limit your opponent. And Sphere Mode as well, because you might not consume your normal summon that much on this deck. And then next we have Earl Camara. So yeah, it's the same decklist from earlier. And then next we have Azrak Guild Tournament. We do have a lot of decklists here from Azrak. We have Alfred Zamora, Scarecrow Horse Adventurer. I guess it's the same decklist as earlier from his Davao Mindanao Tournament. And then next we have Mekanko from Shem Quides. So Mekanko, a very good deck right now to go second. It could really destroy boards and destroy a lot of things on the format right now, because you can easily go second and OTK with this deck, and it could make a lot of sense because the format is pretty much unprepared against the decks that are going second right now. And then next we have Salamangre from Darwin Cyril Turingan. So this is the Cybers PH of the Philippines. He's been playing Cybers decks all over the time. So yeah, it really makes a lot of sense that he have been tapping using Salamangre, a quite underrated and unusual deck here on the format, but he still manages to tap on a quite considerable tournament from Azrak. And plays Kaiser Colosseum, nothing too surprising. Most Salamangre decklists here have been prioritizing the going first shenanigans of Kaiser Colosseum and Rivalry. And then next we have our friend from Kaido Willis, Joshua Aureano, with a very different take on Centurion, with a super heavy samurai that gives ceiling and more passage and combos for the Centurion to be able to capitalize on comboing off when going first. And also plays Gamma on the main deck, really interesting, maybe because he's not really afraid of drawing the driver, because he can just use a pendulum to summon it out. So yeah. And then next we have Full Wanderings from another friend from Kaido Willis, MJ Agura. So this is a very interesting Full Wanderings with no hand drops on the main deck, only Shifter, plays Morganite as well and the Fossil Dyna. So this could really stun a lot of players right now on the format, and paired with Lightning Storm and Evenly Match, because Full Wanderings really struggles when going second. They don't have really that mechanic and capability to go second with Ace right now. So yeah, these cards would help you out. And then next we have Jomar Maravillas, purely. So yeah, nothing too extravagant here, just a standard purely list from Jomar. And then next we have Glenn Gutierrez, Sword Soul Tenyi. So yeah, this lineup of Tenyi monsters are quite extensive here. A very TCG-esque approach of Tenyi lineup here for the Sword Soul. And also plays the Heavenly Dragon Circle that can really elevate the ceiling of the deck. And then next we have Christian Patiga, Rescue Ace in Full Spoils. So yeah, this is quite a standard decklist of Rescue Ace, but a different approach because it plays the Synchro Monsters on the extra deck with the Dragster and the Barone and the Savage. And then next we have Lloyd Torok Tokon, Sword Soul, top 12. So yeah, he played the Earth Monster and level 6 monster here from Sword Soul. This is very unusual. Most people don't even use this card on Sword Soul list, but he preferred to play it because he doesn't even have Tenyi on the main deck. So yeah, he will capitalize on this card as well. And then next we have Rodkin, Eslaban, Resonator, Horus Bestial. So yeah, very combo-ish deck here with the Horus and Bestials that has a lot of extenders and using the primary engine of the Resonator here. And then next we have Reden Jude Andalan, another Kaido Willis here with Fire King. Quite standard decklist of Fire King, plays the Super Poly on the side deck. That's the interesting part. Most of the Fire King decklists here are main decking the Super Poly. And then next we have Liante, Sky Striker. So a go second approach on Sky Striker. It's not too unusual, but the going first Sky Striker is the more played version of Sky Striker right now, rather than the going second one. And then next we have Duel Bacolod Tournament. We have Labyrinth here, the champion. So we already have seen two Labyrinth champions, but this time with the Unchained extra deck. So yeah, he played the Unchained extra deck to make the deck more resilient when going second. And then next we have Purely here from Alexis Precioso, our Kaido Willis friend as well. So yeah, played Summon Limit. Like I've said earlier, Summon Limit is pretty much popular on everyone's side deck right now. And the next we have Tom Riddle, Lord Voldemort himself, Unchained. So yeah, this time plays the Super Poly on the main deck. And also, 3 copies of Drolan Lockbird on the main deck. I think this is a good call from him to... what the hell is... I'm thinking of Harry Potter jokes right now, I'm sorry. Drolan Lockbird could really stop the Purely. Yeah, of course. And also Skill Drain on the main deck because Unchained can float around the graveyard and summon out the big boss monsters of Unchained to beat down the opponent. And the next we have Flo Andris here from Radney. So place a book muna on the main deck could really dodge a lot of things right now in the format like Wailer and Infirm. And the next we have Fire King with Dogmatica Engine here from Lawrence. So yeah, Maximus could really help you out to add more complexity on the deck using the Maximus to dump the entities and other stuff like Ferrigit on the extra deck. And then next we have Trap Tricks here from Levan. I think with Sinful Spoils, yeah, this is a more explosive version of Trap Tricks because Sinful Spoils is added to the deck, but I would rather not see the Sinful Spoils on the Trap Tricks because I think Trap Tricks has been struggling on dealing against decks that are much more faster than Trap Tricks. So I would prefer more hand traps or more controlling traps to control the tempo of the game and dictate it. And then next we have Dino from Jinrig, another friend of mine from Kaido Willis. So yeah, standard decklist of Dino, look at those Fossil Dig. And on the side deck, played Cosmic Cyclone of course to respect the back row and Lightning Storm and evenly match. So we have a lot of back row respect on the side deck. And then next we have Horus Centurion. So yeah, this is standard decklist, plays Bestial on the main deck. That's the interesting part here. He played the Lubellion and the Bestial Magnemut and Druid's Worm on the main deck. So yeah, that's pretty much sums about our local metagame report here from Uncrowned Kings. So if you have time, you can visit our page here, Uncrowned Kings Local Metagame Report, and hit the follow button so that you can be more updated on my future contents here on our page. And also, we will also have a second part of this video to cover the October 19 to the last week of October metagame report and decklist review as well. So thank you for watching. Hit the subscribe button if you're not yet subscribed on my YouTube channel. And hit the notification bell if you want to get more updated on my future contents. So see you on the next one. Peace.